We don't crave to eat anything.
Yeah, guys, I was telling Lupita, we were talking with my cousin and my mom like a few days ago. And we touched that thing, ese tema, porque estamos preguntando, ¿qué quieres hacer para Navidad? ¿Y qué vamos a hacer para el Día del Pavo? ¿Qué vamos a hacer para Navidad? And we didn't even know what to do, because everything, like I was telling Lupita, everything we crave nowadays, if you have, I mean, gracias a Dios, not that we say that we're rich and we have a lot of money, but si quieres tamales, vas y compras las cosas para hacer tamales, and it doesn't matter if it's winter or not, like tú vas y... Se me antoja, voy a hacerlo.
Por decir, como nos dejamos ir como por el dinero, por la avaricia, por los carros, por las casas, por todo eso. Y ahí es por donde siempre nos perdemos.
Before, like, we would make tamales and we would be so happy just to eat a tamal. And I'm like, damn, we really do take things for granted. Oigan, que, I know it sounds cliche, pero cuando tus papás te decían, yo cuando tenía tu edad, you're like, oh my God, here we go. Because I'm like that. I think a lot of us are like that. Que nos están contando, we're like, oh my God, like, dude.
Take for granted, for example, the fact that you have a car. Because now, let's be honest, mira, Adriana, whenever I take my kids to school, there's a lady, she takes the bus. I used to be on the buses all the time. Y pedir el mandado.
Uy.
We would have to go on the
bus. Te hablo, Pita, really?
Yeah, no, olvídate, cuando veíamos allá por donde trabajamos antes, nos íbamos hasta el Walmart de la San Mateo caminando y puchando a mi hermano en la carriola para comprar el mandado.
Holy crap. Hola, Molcas.
Welcome back to Compartiendo
Mitote with
Lupita
and Adilene.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to our episode number 57.
Yes. As you guys can see, can you tell we got tired of dressing up? We're tired today. We're comfy today.
We got in the comfy mood today.
Yes, and it's really cold.
Me with my slippers. I'm like, slipper time, hoodie time. It's the best time of the year.
I didn't even do my hair, honestly.
No, it's been cold. Y luego, besides that, I feel que we've been so busy this past weeks that it has just been so hard.
Yeah, life, holidays. ¿Qué más? Muchas salidas, ¿no? Hemos tenido que no parece, like, we
Because we've been doing other things, but, o sea, like, we've been busy with just regular your life, how you said
work
and getting ready for the holidays, because I feel like once October hit, everything went like, because we're about to hit the last week of November and then we're about to come into the holiday spirit, like, well, like Christmas. People already put up their trees and everything. Yo todavía ni pongo el pino.
No, neither am I. I was telling Lupita, I have a cousin who's staying with us, and she's so excited. She wants to put the tree. I think she'll put it on Saturday, she said. But she's been wanting to put it, but our tree was too skinny, too empty, according to her. So she wanted to get a new one, and we got a new one. My mom got a new one from her friend. So let's see how that one is, because they haven't even opened it yet. But it looks big.
Really? Oh, she's going to have a blast decorating it.
Oh, sí, se va a dar vuelo.
She's going to be like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
She's in the mood. I was telling Lupita in the bathroom, she already put the shower curtain. She put toallas, like red, and then this, like, white with green, and has, like, a little Santa Claus. I'm like, damn. Ya no falta tapete.
She's so excited.
She is excited.
Well, it's because the holidays are really, like...
Joyful,
but, like, real, like, sentimental, like, it brings families together. It's a time that you get together. It's a time that you get to talk and enjoy and watch movies and do things, play games, you know, just, like, enjoy your family. It's a time of the year that you actually get to disconnect from the world and your job and your things, and you actually get to enjoy your family.
That's true.
I don't know. I honestly do love Christmas. Is my favorite time of the year.
Mine too.
Because
Christmas.
To me, as soon as November is falling, I'm like, hi.
Oh, it's because it's her birthday too.
It's my birthday. See? It's Christmas. It's New Year's. It's just party.
Lupita's favorite hobby. Just kidding.
Yeah. I'm like, oh yes, I like this.
I love it.
Sign me up.
You're ready. Yeah. Pues ya mero, no worries. Ya mero, ya te va a llegar.
Ya mero. And I'm excited. I'm like, oh, next week I want to put up. As soon as en cuanto que pase Thanksgiving, because I wanted to put it before, but I was telling Adelana that my son is like, no, like, Thanksgiving is not over. Like, you need to leave the pumpkins and all the fall decor. And I was like, okay. So I'm like, muy triste. On Friday, phew! Putting away all the pumpkins.
You know what you reminded me of? Last time we were driving like to school, I was taking my daughter, and the leaves on the trees were falling, and it was so pretty, like just seeing them like fall. Mm-hmm. I don't know why I was like, in every tree I was like.
And then the colors. Sí. Because yeah, it's almost like yellowish, greenish, y luego cafecitas, and like naranjitas y mm-hmm. como rojizas.
Sí.
They look so pretty. Yeah, a mí me gustan sí. mucho las rojas. And whenever you go like by the river, because you know how all the trees are there, mm-hmm. they're tan bonitos.
Sí, like, but pictures, man.
Yeah, it looks so pretty.
Definitely.
Yeah, so next week I'm putting down the pumpkins.
Baby pumpkins. Hello. Yeah. Hello Christmas, Santa Christmas. Claus and reindeers or ¿qué más hay de eso? Nutcrackers.
Santa Claus, gingerbreads, snowmen.
Trees.
Y ahorita se están usando mucho the bowls.
Oh yeah.
Oh, they look so pretty.
My cousin did one and she sold it, guys. It was a huge ass. Excuse the language. Bowl. It was red, but it was like big and like casi bien largo. She sold it for $100, but she kind of regretted it because I guess now they go like for almost $200. People pay that for a bowl.
Really? Oh my god.
But sí, lo que me está diciendo mi prima que se están usando mucho los moños en los árboles de Navidad.
Yeah, en los árboles de Navidad, like this year, I feel like it's trending.
Sí.
Like el moño. And then, pero no los moños así tan así como como 3D. Like the ajá, pero los moños que están así como caídos así para abajo, como aesthetic,
como like muy girly, los que nos ponemos
sí, como muy girly. Yeah, those are the type of bowls que están usando mucho ahorita.
Mm-hmm.
They look pretty.
Sí, they honestly. Look pretty. I bought some from Shein. And my cousin, she's like, where did you get this bowl from? They go, Shein. Mm-hmm. And it's in every color, like the fall, like black, white, cafecito, café. And it was actually for Isabella, but I was like, I'm going to wear those too.
Even though, I know. I share with my daughter too. I'm like, oh, I bought them for us.
Don't lose them.
Don't lose them. And then she gets on my earrings and she saw, like, it's because we share. I was like, yeah.
I guess so. I know.
But yeah.
So today, guys, we wanted to talk about Thanksgiving and being grateful, right?
Mm-hmm. Last year, if you remember, we did a Friendsgiving. It was our first ever Friendsgiving. I'm not acuerdo here eating churches.
Church's chicken?
Church's chicken.
Closest thing to turkey.
We had our, and we had our Friendsgiving. And me and Adelina were talking about it. Well, Adelina brought up the conversation. And she was like, how come now on the holidays, like, we don't crave to eat anything?
Yeah, guys, I was telling Lupita, we were talking with my cousin and with my mom like a few days ago. And we touched that thing, ese tema, porque estamos preguntando, ¿qué quieres para Navidad? ¿Y qué vamos a hacer para el Día del Pavo? ¿Qué vamos a hacer para Navidad? And we didn't even know what to do because everything, like I was telling Lupita, everything we crave nowadays, if you have, I mean, gracias a Dios, not that we say that we're rich and we have a lot of money, but si quieres tamales, vas y compras las cosas para hacer tamales, and it doesn't matter if it's winter or not, like tú vas y se me antoja, voy a hacerlo. Que quiero hacer empanadas, órale, ahí voy a hacerlas. ¿Qué más? Chicharrones o like cosas así, cualquier cosa que se te antoje, like you go and buy it and just do it. So now when it comes to like Thanksgiving dinner or Christmas, you don't crave anything. Like menudo, you eat maybe every Saturday or Sunday. Pozole, maybe you eat it once a week. I don't know, like es más accesible.
Yeah, maybe because thank God we are blessed and we have the opportunity to choose what to eat.
Mm-hmm.
But not everyone has that opportunity. And I feel like maybe, because I was telling Adelena that too, I was like, because I was seeing this video of this influencer and they were in Mexico, remember? Mm-hmm.
Sí.
And she was celebrating like their sweet 15 o su quinceañera, whatever. Aquí es el sweet 16. Bueno, como sea, la quinceañera. And I was like, o sea, like economic wise, era muy limitada, ¿verdad? Para lo que tú estás acostumbrado a ver, porque la gente aquí avienta 20 mil, 30 mil dólares, aunque sacrifiquen un pulmón.
Y un grupo del otro que riñón está bien bonito,
para
flores.
Para poderles hacer todo lo que quieran, ¿verdad? Pero carros. I was starting to tell Elena, they look so happy.
Sí.
And I was telling her, it's because I feel they appreciate all the little things because they don't have them. And at one point, we're just losing our gratitude towards anything that we have because we're just like, oh, no, like, mañana lo hago, or mm-hmm. I'll buy it later, or whatever. Mm-hmm. Esta es una cosa, me atrasé algo que hablamos. Este miércoles hablamos en la iglesia de eso.
Mm-hmm.
Y este miércoles dijo el Señor, dijo, cuando Jesús fue tentado 3 veces por el diablo,
mm-hmm.
dijo, entonces nos preguntó, ¿qué fue lo que le ofreció el diablo? Entonces, en una de esas veces que el diablo lo tentó, lo llevó así como arriba y lo se veía así como todo el mundo. Y le dijo, yo te puedo dar lo que tú quieras del mundo.
Mm-hmm.
Y entonces pues Jesús dijo que no, vea, pero la enseñanza de eso es que todo lo que hay en el mundo exactamente pues le pertenece a quién. ¿Quién se lo quería dar a Jesús?
El diablo.
Ajá. Porque nos dejamos
como ir las cosas mundanas, sí, como dicen. Como,
o sea, por decir, como nos dejamos ir como por el dinero, por la avaricia, por los carros, por las casas, por todo eso. Y ahí es por donde siempre nos perdemos.
Mm-hmm. Y es por donde llegar.
Ajá. And I was like, oh, like, o sea, it made sense. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
You know what? Hemos tocado también un poco este tema de que los artistas en veces, like nowadays too, muchos, bueno, pensamos, no estamos 100% seguros de que venden su alma al diablo y cosas así por tener dinero o porque les vaya bien o por tener la fama y por tener todas estas cosas, ¿verdad? Y ahora que me pongo a pensar, like, think about it, that's why, like, casi como lo hemos dicho antes, que como nosotros, que ya las cosas las vemos como que, ah, son tamales, ah, es menudo, like, we can eat that any other day. It doesn't matter. That's probably how rich people see everything else, like, material-wise, because they already have everything. So they're like, ah, like, I can get whatever I want. Like, you kind of get what I'm trying to explain.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe that's where they get that from, también. Pero ya, yeah, like, we...
Es así como
nos somos agradecidos.
Pones greedy.
Like,
bueno, no, así
no
como
greedy,
like,
como ungrateful. Uh-huh. Just ungrateful, yeah.
Just like, you
it's
can
whatever.
Have anything whenever you want.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Pues es que sí, es que I feel like we have, over the time, we have lost our, like, our gratitude.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we don't give, mira, honestamente, and I'm gonna be really honest, because I don't do that either. Apenas mm-hmm. estoy empezando. Like, blessing our food. Like, mm-hmm. never. Y sabes una cosa, yo sí me acuerdo con mis abuelitos,
mm-hmm.
they would pray. Antes de que comíamos, we would always pray, aunque fuera frijoles. Like, we would always pray. And mis abuelitos en las mm-hmm. noches, antes de dormir, they would always pray. All the time. And, like, como eso, yo, por decir, yo lo perdí, I didn't do that for a long period of time. Honestamente, hasta apenas ahorita que estoy yendo mm-hmm. mis clasecitas, and I'm like, oh! Yeah, I need to change that. And mm-hmm. I'm like, oh, see, like, I'm wrong there, or, you know.
And you know what? Like, we've no, talked about this too. De la comida, porque you never know, like, what they're feeding you. So you're like, before anything else happens. Like, ahora en día, like, nowadays que I look, el E. coli is everywhere. Did you hear about the carrots too?
I know, apenas había comido mis carrots.
Yo comí ayer. Espero en Dios y no. Pues ya estoy ahí comiendo.
No, pero sí. Son organic. No?
Oh, ah, okay.
Because they said the organic. Because I bought the other ones, las que no son organic.
Uh-huh.
Las he querido tirar, because I was like, apenas las compré y me las quiero comer con ranch. Pero mi esposo dijo, like, las zanahorias. I was like, ah. Pero, like, mañana dije, en la tarde dije, voy a chequear bien.
Yo so, también, porque yo ya
está organic.
Yo hasta iba a comer, ni modo. Ya dijeron, like, the next day I was like, oh shit, I just bought, like, I don't know, it's been a while.
Uh-huh.
Porque hice un caldo, dije, pues ya, si me toca, me toca. Wow.
Well, I already no, ate them. But, o sea, hay muchas cosas como dices tú,
mm-hmm.
sí, las enfermedades and things like that, but there's other things that people put things.
Maldades.
Yeah, sí. they will put you your... Y casi siempre cuando te pasan cosas así, it always happens with something that you have ate.
Sí.
Mm-hmm.
you feel it right away. Oh, bueno, no te cae bien. Mm-hmm. Like something not cooked right or something. But yeah, that's a good tradition, I think, that we should probably not
lose.
And especially like for Thanksgiving. Because you know what, too? I feel like antes, or my grandma, I don't know who it was, like they were trying to make us like say something around the table. Y ahora ni más. Es más, a veces hombres que hemos comer todos juntos, pero casi nunca se puede porque we don't have the space for all of us to sit in one table and eat. But, because always, casi siempre it's the kids first and then us, the adults, so we never really eat all together. But it's nice, like that, like traditions like that, que órale, todos digan algo. Mm-hmm. Porque then we lose why we're even celebrating Thanksgiving for starters.
And what's I think, when did I do that? That was one time when I went to Vegas. Uh-huh. And I met a cousin of a friend, and she had a Thanksgiving dinner. She invited us, and that was the first time I ever do that, because she did that. She was like, oh, we're gonna go around the table and we're gonna say what we're grateful for, and then we're gonna do our prayer, and then we're gonna eat. Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh, this is cute. But como tú dices, like as time progresses, because we're so busy with the world, and like neta, not to be mean, but like los comerciales and the pressure, because it's like, oh, this is new, this is new, this is new, this is new.
Oh, yes.
And then they're freaking not letting your things that you have already update, because ya quieren que compres el siguiente, and it's like, o sea, hold on, like wait. Entonces, like we just get so involved on that, on those things, and then we lose our gratitude, we lose our what's actually important.
Uh-huh, things actually matter. Yeah, because we were talking about this too, like, well, the same thing, pero con mi mamá, like, she said, like, this before, like, we would make tamales and we would be so happy just to eat a tamale, and I'm like, damn, like, we really do take things for granted. Oigan, que, I know it sounds cliche, pero cuando tus papás te decían, yo cuando estaría tu edad, you're like, oh my God, here we go. Because I'm like that. I think a lot of us are like that. Que nos están contando, we're like, oh my God, like, dude, you're not there over there anymore. Like, you're like, it's a new era.
I feel that's like my kids, like, whenever I tell them. Because es una cosa, like, no creo que a mí me dijeran, because honestly, we were poor. We didn't have, like, nothing. Like, we were very poor. And, like, pues no, dijo yo lo que fuera. Like, that's why maybe I'm not picky at all, because I don't care. I'm like, lo que sea.
Ay, Lupita.
Yeah.
Pero,
like, I feel sometimes, like, last time, ¿cuándo fue? A couple months ago, fuimos a comer, my husband, and then my son and me. And, yeah, because Nico stayed with my brother. And then we were eating, and I was telling my husband, I was like, oh my God, I was like, how lucky am I? I was like, my parents never took me out to eat. Like, they never.
I know. And you know what? That's something I think we have to kind of work on, having our kids appreciate things. Because my daughter, I feel like, sometimes she's like, Mom, I hate my life. I'm like, what do you hate about it? Like, dude, like, you get everything you want. You're very spoiled. Like, ¿por qué? Like, why? I wish my mom would do this. I wish that I did this. And you got to do it. Like, I told Lupita too, she's been to Disneyland, like, I don't know how many times, every time for her birthday. Because there's kids that never even go, and you've been there, like, already in your 8 years of life, like, 3 or 4 times. Like, dude, like, you need to appreciate that. But I don't know how to teach her that. But I do need to teach her, because I don't want to make a spoiled brat. Cuando crezcan, que es, oh!
No, because it's true, like, sometimes I'm like, sometimes, like, como dices tú, like, it feels, like, repetitive, because the poor child is like, oh my God, here we go again, you're so review, being poor, you this,
we know,
you that,
we know.
But I'm like, do you know? Like, mira, neta, not to be mean ni nada, but whenever Trump won, and then my son, he's all telling my husband, ahora sí, háblale a mi abuela, dile que está en la vida, and I was like,
really?
And dude? Dude, si no fuera por nosotros, no comes. Like, what?
Yeah, it's
like, how can you be so
grateful? See, because we're selfish.
I feel like we don't value, like, the hard work,
the sacrifice.
Others, the sacrifice.
That's one thing. You know what? On TikTok, they siempre topan este tema donde sometimes los papás sacrifican, like, they come to another. Mm-hmm. Think about it, guys. Everything
it's
about
easy.
Just isn't, yeah, it's not.
Acuérdate,
like, we give props.
Mandes, when they told us their stories, our mothers.
Yeah, and we want to share that maybe one of these days too, when more into that A ver cómo les fue. Ya viniendo para acá. But, like the transition. But yeah, it's not easy. Imagine you going to a different country. You don't know the language. You don't know the culture. You don't know nothing. Like nada. You don't even know where you're going. To be honest. You've never been there. So you don't know. Everything es algo desconocido. Entonces, they learn to make money or have a job. They learn...
They sacrifice. To go look for a job. To give you a better life.
Them,
like, oh, okay, vas a ir de 8 a whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But they're there, like, on time, ready to go. They save their money. They sacrifice. Like, you can see their hands, like, whenever they have come from working, you know.
Construction, cleaning houses.
Mechanics, electricians, plumbing. Like, it's not an easy job. And, like, I just feel just, like... You need to appreciate that that person is actually going out there and bringing here to your house bread and to have a roof shelter for you.
Yeah, and then, like, they sacrifice leaving their family behind, leaving everything they know in the place where they're born from for you. Like, think about it, guys.
For something new. For something they never thought.
For you to have that opportunity that they didn't have, to go to school, to finish, to have a better paying job, un trabajo donde no te mates tanto, como dicen ellos, like, oh no. Which you do, stressfully, mentally, not physically.
No trabajas, nomás estás sentada ahí en la oficina, ni haces nada. ¿Qué vas a hacer?
Yes. Because
your brain's like, brr.
Quemado. Yeah, like that, but yeah, like that's, I think that's another big one that, things sometimes we don't appreciate. What's other things that you think we don't appreciate?
We take for granted, for example, the fact that you have a car. Because now, let's be honest, mira, Diana, whenever I take my kids to school, there's a lady, she takes the bus. I've seen her. Like, the bus comes this way, and she gets off, and she goes, drops off the daughter. Y como the airport's right here, so se echa la vuelta el bus y regresa. So se apura la señora to, like, come back to the stop on the other side so she can get the bus back. And I'm like, we have to be grateful that we have a vehicle. You know, it doesn't matter que sea, whatever it is.
We're the year make
we
model.
Have it. Like, we're able to drive ourselves and go, because there's people that are not able to drive themselves.
At whatever time. Sin estarle pidiendo favores a nadie, que te hagan como las caras, que se te pase el camión, que el camión dura un buen. Que no sabes usar el camión. Yo nunca me subo en un camión de esos, ni sé cómo funciona.
Yo sí, ahorita es gratis. Después del COVID. Bueno, antes se había andado en el camión.
It's hard.
Entonces echabas coritas, ¿no? Like, te cobraban como 25, 35 centavos, and then you would put it, and they would give you, like, a little ticket, and then te sentabas, y ese ticket te servía para regresar para atrás.
But how do you know where to get off or where to get on and all that?
Because well, I feel like stop. That's... You know, there's the little...
Yeah, but, like, how do you know? Like, I'm going to get from point A to point B. Like, how the hell do you know? Because I see them...
Because the buses, like, nomás de norte a sur... Sí, de norte a sur, o de este a oeste. That's how they route. Like, they don't go, like, como los carros. No, they just, like, si te vas a subir a Montgomery, Montgomery nomás va a ir de este a oeste. No va a ir para otro lado, nomás ahí.
You can't get anything else to take you to the
other
side.
You have to get the other bus.
Oh, damn.
Y luego ya, si vas a dar la course, un ejemplo, de norte a sur. So, yeah, you have to go.
Y luego, that
pues,
sucks.
Depende del lado, por decir, que cuando el camión va así, ¿verdad? Pues, o sea... Depende, acá están las paradas. Y si ya te vas a venir de niño, pues es del otro lado. And then inside the buses, well, cuando yo me había subido hace añitos, they have, like, little strings. So you would pull it, like, whenever you would see, like, the street it's coming, the stuff it's coming. So you would, like, pull it. And they had, like, a little TV and it would tell you.
I would not know how to get around those guys.
I haven't been in the bus in, like, a good while.
A long time.
I used to be on the buses all the time. Y pedir el mandado.
Uy.
We would have to go on the
bus. Te hablo, Peter, ¿really?
Yeah, no, olvídate, cuando veíamos ahí, allá por donde trabajamos antes, nos íbamos hasta el Walmart de la San Mateo caminando y puchando a mi hermano en la carriola para comprar el mandado.
Holy crap.
And he was, estaba bien chubby, estaba bien pesado. Like, puchando, I was like,
sin aire.
Yeah.
Damn.
Mm-hmm. Like, por eso te digo, like, honestamente, like, I feel we take even for granted the fact that we get to be able to go to the grocery store and buy the things.
And put them in the car.
Honestamente, like, I remember que, like, no podía comprar el cereal que yo quería. I had to buy the one they told me because we didn't have money.
Damn, Lupita. Y yo que me quejo por echar el... Es más, por echar el... Bajar el mandado. Oh, I hate it.
As I'm telling you, like, sometimes, yeah, like, nos quejamos de esas cosas, but then we don't see, like, the we're so side. Grateful, like, we're able to go, pick, and choose, and put in the car. Esta me sirve como ejercicio. Una caminadita ahí por el Walmart, whatever, or cements, whatever you want to do. And then you come back, ¿no?
That's true.
The fact that you have a TV to watch, yo ni televisión tenía. Es más, you know where we got our first TV whenever we got here? Like, you know how la gente ponía, like, cosas next to the trash can?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's how we got it. Someone put the TV there.
Dijo, someone's like, trash, oh, is someone else's treasure.
Yeah. And we're like, oh, a TV! Let me bring it in.
Nice.
Yeah, that was our first TV ever.
Did y'all fight for the control? Yeah.
No eran ni de control, eran las que le daban.
Oh, damn! Damn, Lupita. Damn.
Yeah.
Y mi papá nomás nos peleábamos por el control. I remember he would play with me and just like hide it from me trying to get it all the time because we would fight over the control.
Really?
Damn.
But see, that's a privilege. Not that everyone has it.
Yeah, that's right. You know what? I think we also kind of desapreciamos the time. Mm-hmm. Like, now as we get older, like, yo me acuerdo que antes te dicen, like, do everything you want because then you're going to get old and then this and that. Like, o oh, así, like, te dicen que el tiempo se va volando. We're like, yeah, whatever. Like, oh, ahí voy otra vez. Cuando nos dicen, yeah, whatever, that's a hint that there's, like, something that is true. Del rato antes están, like, oops. Because I feel like after you turn 15, time, like, flies by.
Yeah.
And, like,
an adult life, oof.
Ooh, mas.
Forget it. Vamos in turbo mode.
Yeah, like, now that I'm almost 30, I'm like, Lupita, that's already a third of her life. Holy shit, así que he hecho nada.
Pero third. Sabes una cosa, Lene? Something too, that we are focused on the time. Because
mm-hmm.
nosotros vivimos enfocados en el tiempo, like, oh, tomorrow, oh, Friday, oh, Saturday.
Oh, the weekend, uh-huh. We look forward to the weekend to do everything we want to do. You know what? That made me kind of think about, like, ahora que estaba viendo otras cosas, like, locas me tienen toda, like, ah, we're gonna die, and this is gonna happen, and pandemics, and we're gonna get sick, and then it is gonna go away, like, I don't know, all these conspiracy theories, sometimes I go crazy. I know, I shouldn't watch them. But anyways, like, stuff like that, and I'm like, holy shit, like, does everything we want, like, money-wise, does it really matter? Because cuando no vamos a morir, no vamos a morir, y... God, I mean, your money doesn't count for nothing. All the time you work, tampoco. And I'm like, like all those dreams you have, maybe también. I'm like,
Es que sabes una cosa, mira ahí. Going back to the time, every day can be your weekend. It's just how you see and you perceive things.
Como lo estamos.
The thing is que nosotros estamos enfocados en mañana voy a trabajar. Otra cosa, porque ¿cuántos nos resonamos con que mañana voy a trabajar? Be grateful, you have a job. Mm-hmm. There's people that don't have a job, you know. My neighbor was here for like a month. He didn't have a job.
Yeah, that's like, true.
O sea, we take it for granted. We take it like, nah, whatever.
We think nothing's gonna happen and we're always gonna have it. Yeah, that's kind of true.
Yeah, pero no, no andes viendo cosas de conspiración.
I know, it had me all crazy. It's because, I don't know, guys, it's kind of crazy. Like, now with all this... Dijo ahora para tocar un poquito ese tema. Did aliens come from the ocean?
Otro estás como el del bueno, la mala y el feo. And I was like, oh my god, do it again.
Es que think about it, Lupita. I remember there was a fire or something in the water not so long ago. It's starting to make sense. The military is fighting the aliens.
Oh, did you saw the interview? There's an interview. Because on the radio, they talked about an interview. So I think it's three agents or something like that that they declare on the Congress about the aliens.
Oh, is it the algo? Están ahí en el Senado hablando de todo eso.
Sí, sí. De ahí salió el de la radio. And I was like, oh my god.
Sí, they said it. But you know what? I think it was kind of a distraction. Y nosotros allá caemos bien redonditos con lo de Pitiria y estamos todos. Y
Yeah, I don't know. Like, yo también porque lo escuché en el radio and they talked about it esta semana.
It's crazy, Lupita. Es que neta, like, all those things, like, make sense. I remember there was a fire, I don't remember, or something in the water where there was, like, an explosion and they didn't know, they couldn't explain why. Well, guess what? Now that we know there's fucking aliens, they're fighting the aliens. And then there's this video on TikTok when these people are, like, are in a ship and you can see them and on a helicóptero, like, shooting down on the... Like, these things that go flying off, and I'm like, holy shit, those are aliens. It's kind of crazy that it took us this long
for them to say that they're real. Avatar.
Oh, like, sí, when the tap
shoots. You know, whenever they're shooting. Tiene que ver con el agua.
Sí. Uh-huh. See? And then, you know what's the weirdest thing? I don't know if you guys have ever heard this. I haven't read the whole Bible. But también dicen que some people believe, like, the water is, like, God. Like, it's... No, that's because I'm not gonna be able to show you guys a lot because I haven't read it, but I've heard something like that. And I'm like, because they say there's a world underneath the water. Think about it. Remember what they only said, that they only know 10% of the water? Do you think they're lying? I think they're lying.
I don't think they're lying porque honestamente, like, whenever you go into the ocean, Adelana, it's very intimidating. Like,
it's neta, huge. Like, it's scary.
Like, tú te paras ahí on the shore and then you see, like,
the
water, you see the waves, you see, like, la fuerza
que tiene
con la
mar.
Que viene el agua, that it will throw you off, like, mm-hmm. nothing. And at that point, like, even whenever you go to, like, como cuando viste a la isla de Catalina,
mm-hmm.
right? All you see is blue, like, mm-hmm. everywhere. Like, it's water, 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 water.
Yeah, not dirt.
And, like, how are we humans supposed to know what's actually in there when, like... Un barquito, que es un barcote, cuando lo vemos acá anclado, allá es una cosita así chiquita.
Sí, sí, es que está inmenso. Pues, ¿cuánto es el porcentaje de tierra?
Es más agua que tierra, ¿no?
Sí.
No me acuerdo cuál es el porcentaje, pero sí es más agua que tierra.
Sí. Y luego, ¿saben que hay otra? Ahí voy con mis conspiracies. South Pole, North Pole también, like, hay cosas que esconden. Que hay un, like, hole and there's, like, no one can go in there. And then, you know what, guys? It's kind of crazy how these type of topics we're so scared of. And I think that's why they don't tell us. Because then we'll go more crazy than we already are. See, así.
Es que sabes una cosa, Elena, that's also true. Like, you can't be all the time thinking of the future.
Sí.
Because that's... We don't enjoy our present to be thinking of the future.
Mm-hmm.
Who knows? ¿Qué va a pasar? Who knows?
Hopefully, I'll be dead, but then...
I know.
But then my daughter...
Who knows? Like, only God knows.
Mm-hmm.
But why would you stress over something that we don't even know?
If we're gonna even make it to...
Like,
does that work about that
within 10 years, 20 years? And, like, we don't even know about...
It's because there's people who time travel.
Oh,
I heard... This is another case, guys. It's called Casa 63. My cousin showed it to me and I can't stop watching it. También, but I stopped because I was like, I'm going crazy. Jorge was like... My boyfriend was like, stop watching it. You're going crazy. Like, you're going to get crazy. Read the Bible if you want to read something crazy. I'm like, no, the Bible's kind of boring. Like, it's just old stuff. And you know what? It's so crazy. You know what? That I know that I've been reading the Bible. There's some stories in there that they're like... Y luego dicen, ay, no, es que ahora los tiempos de ahora están muy feos. Are you sure about that? Because if you read the Bible, there's some weird stuff in the Bible, to be honest. Like, there's this story, like, remember I told you?
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's a story, don't tell me where, because I don't know where it was, like, what it's called, or how to, like,
reference libro.
De que las hijas, like, had, they got their dad drunk,
So ¿Estás leyendo el Nuevo Testamento, el Viejo Testamento que estás leyendo?
I don't even know, honestly. It's for kids. I don't know, I downloaded it from an app and for Isabella to read. Pero there's some inappropriate stuff in there. I was like, are you sure this is for kids? that they didn't want to lose their bloodline, so they got their dad drunk and they had intimate relationships with the dad so they can have, like, kids. But I was like, what? Like, I was already...
Un incesto.
Yes. I mean, I guess it kind of makes sense back then, because, I mean, we all did come kind of, I think, from incest, because there's only two people, and those two people four, you see, ¿no? So they would have
interest. Como los pueblos. Because, you know, like, ¿sabes una cosa? Like, me recuerda mucho me exposing my husband. El pueblo de mi esposo, but whenever they have, like, talks, oh, ya se va a poner bueno. Dijo, mañana comienzan las... Las mañana que voy a seguir repasando con todo el pueblito. I don't even know. And then I'm over here. Oh, who? Why? Where? they talk about que como que se relacionaron todos entre familia. I was like, what?
It happens. It's like, very often.
How many people live in there?
I don't know how true this is, but I saw on TikTok también como en Zacatecas hay mucho de eso.
Que se casan primos con primas y tíos con tías y
yes, yeah. And that's why I think we're all so, because you know how they say that.
Oh, sí, porque dicen que si es como un familiar muy cercano no está bien, no puedes it tener impacts. Problemas. No desarrollaste bien.
Sí. Yeah, it's crazy. We got off topic there, but
I know. From gratitude to something else.
Conspiracies and little chisme.
I know.
No, yeah, guys. No, but yeah. We need to work on being grateful. And you know what, too? On TikTok, I've also heard, like, when you're grateful, more things come to you.
Yeah. And when you see things positive things will come to you.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's the law, like, the law of attraction.
Mm-hmm.
Pero también, like, what would you say it's your advice for you to start being grateful? Like, what would you advise someone, like, hey, like,
just say
this
it.
This is, like, something that will help you get started.
I think just, like, accepting it and saying it out loud, like, I'm thankful for this. Like, I don't know if you guys, like, even in the morning, like, I'm gonna expose myself a little bit. Like, yo siempre que me subo a mi carro me digo, okay, le digo, gracias, Cito, pero otro día más de trabajo, de vida y salud. So, que tengamos un buen día. And that's all I say in the morning. And it makes me feel good. And every time I say it, like, I have a good day. And I'm like, huh. But then sometimes I'm like, oh, rough, shiny, voy bien tarde, no sé, and then everything goes like southward, like, se va todo mal, and I'm like, what the hell? Oh, I haven't said it.
Yeah.
Just get into the routine of saying it.
Para ti sería como tu oración.
Yeah. In the morning, and I try to tell Isabella we don't do it all night, because I'm a lie if I do say it, I do it at night, but I have told Isabella, like, say thank you for this, that, you have a house, there's people who don't have a house, ahí vamos a empezar con la misma, but it's true, like, digo, you have a house, maybe this is not our house, but we live here, like, we have somewhere to live, we have cobijas, we have four walls, we have food, we're good.
Mm-hmm.
What about you? What do you think would help you? Start.
Sabes que yo le regalé esto a una de mis compañeras. Because she was very, like, always thinking negative and always thinking negative. And I told her, the first thing you need to switch is your mindset.
Uh-huh.
And I told her, I'm gonna give you a gratitude book. And I told her, I want you to start writing down what you're thankful for.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like when you actually, like, write it down and you see it, it, like, clicks into your mind, mm-hmm. and you're like, oh, like, I do have things to be grateful for. You know
mm-hmm.
what I mean? Like,
even though you have to think about it.
Yeah, because I feel whenever you have such a negative, like, mindset,
mm-hmm.
you need to break your negative mindset. Because mm-hmm. that's what's bringing you worriness, anxiety, stress, lack of sleep. Because you're always worrying about things that are not even existent. It's just your mind playing you off.
That's true, and that makes sense, because así como estás diciendo, you're thinking, you're like, it's like homework. Like, mm-hmm. you're thinking, y luego te pones a pensar, okay, I have this, okay, yeah, I do have that, and then you read it, you're like, oh yeah, like, you're right, like, you juntas uno y uno.
Yeah, because of course, like, you have to put God first, yes, but you also have to start working on your mindset and the way you think and see things, because you're always... One of the pastors told me this last week, and mm-hmm. she was like, you're always going to have problems. That's not the problem. The mm-hmm. problem is how you react to the problem.
You know what? Now that you tell me that, ya es que siempre lo hemos platicado el viejito, el José,
mm-hmm.
de la clínica, his attitude was always really, like, positive. And he really, like, really taught me, guys, because now that I'm in this other job and I see people, like, complaining all the time, I'm like, dude, just, like, be quiet. Just do it. Like, be happy. Like, we have a job. Nos pagan no tan mal. Like, it's okay. Like, you're here to work. Mm-hmm. That's what we're getting paid for, to work. So, like, ¿para qué se quejan? Like, me desesperan. I'm like, ¿cómo tiene que ver la actitud de la gente?
Mm-hmm.
Un buen.
Yeah, like... The way you react and the way you see things, mm-hmm. it's going to make a huge difference.
Impact.
Yeah, because es muy diferente venir del trabajo, servirte unos frijoles y comértelos enojados y decir, ay, nomás tengo que comer frijoles. Es muy diferente que vengas y que sabes, ay, qué rico, me como unos frijolitos con sí. queso, con mi tortita.
Ha tratado de saber
un chilito curtido, yummy. Es muy diferente, pero eso fue tu actitud.
Sí.
Sí, and you have to like switch that on your mindset. Like first you need God, but after that, like you need to start working on your mindset. You need to start being strong.
Yeah, that's true.
Because we all, like, ¿sabes qué una cosa? Yo creo que all human beings, like, we always tend to think negative because that's just how the brain works. Like, the brain is always with that negative, like, negative comment that's or the negative first thing something. You go to. It goes to negative. And then you have to break it and be like,
no.
No.
It's low end.
Yeah.
Yeah. Definitely, guys.
Yeah. But what are you thankful for this Thanksgiving?
This Thanksgiving, I'm thankful. Well, I have a lot of things to be thankful.
Good.
Look, think about it. We've been like working on this, like we kept getting different jobs, and I don't know, like it's kind of weird with that. Like I don't know. I guess I'm thankful for this new job, even though sometimes I complain about it. I'm talking about attitude. Just kidding. But quería trabajar, está mi trabajo. But I'm thankful for it because I've already seen like, oh, like it's a little bit more money, so I'm a little bit less stressed. I'm thankful that I finally paid off my car. I'm thankful that we have a good health. And I am also thankful for, I think that's it for now. Yeah, what about
your family?
También, but sometimes, but dijo la thinking. Saying about being thankful and being appreciated.
You're like, nah.
I see them all the time, just kidding.
Oh my God.
I know, you know what? Let me tell you so you guys can laugh. So this Thanksgiving, it's only going to, well, Christmas, we were talking about it and we think it's only going to be us three. And then my mom was like, I'm okay with you guys. I'm like, no, I'm not. Me being ungrateful. I was like, I want more people, just us three. Y le dice, mamá, ¿no quieres compartirte? El chiste es compartir con nosotros. Le digo, sí, para compartir con ustedes todos los días. Like every day we're together, so what's something new? And she's like, oh. I was like, I know. Shut up, Adelina, shut up. Let me be too honest.
Adelina.
It's true.
I'm tired.
I know. I know. Well, es que no vamos a contar si todos los días nos contamos lo que nos pasa, because I mean, I already know everything. You already know about everything about me, and vice versa.
Maybe you can play games.
True. It's because it's hard. You know what, guys? That's another thing. For Thanksgiving, it's so hard to play games with older people. Because first, English. El idioma. Porque no todos los juegos están en español.
I saw this one en la mañana en Despierta América. I was like, oh, I want to try it. Es en una cajita de Kleenex. ¿Verdad? Pues saca los Kleenex o deja la pura cajita vacía. O si van a tener Kleenex en tu oficina, las cajitas.
No, son bien tacaños ni nada.
No. No les pones un string, like on the back, and then you put it like here, and inside you filled it up with leathers, like feathers, leathers, la otra, feathers.
Leather, I was like, what?
I'm all, feathers. No, te digo, el inglés no es lo mío. And you fill it up with the feathers. Se los ponen aquí en la cintura. And then, like, you have to take all, like, moviéndote, you have to, like, get all the feathers out.
Oh, como el de las pelotitas, pero con feathers.
Y luego, they did one with the cups. So, las de plástico, and then they put uno de un color, como en medio. And then you have to, like, get it, and get it from the top, and put it on the bottom. Oh, yeah. Get it from the top, and put it from the bottom. And mira, nosotros estamos bien impuestos a, like, shoot. And it's like the opposite way.
Oh.
Yeah, because you have to do it like from the top to the bottom.
Oh, to the bottom.
To the bottom. We're used to like, shoo.
And look at me, I just was doing this right now.
Yeah. And I was like, oh, that's cool. They did that one. I was like, oh, that's fun. What else did they do? Oh, I saw this one too. Like maybe for Thanksgiving. I was like, oh, this is cool. I want to do one.
It's fun.
And
I love playing games.
Como disfrazando el pavo. So you basically get a turkey, coloring turkey page. And then, ya sean revistas o feathers o cositas, lo que tú quieras. And then you like put it on the table and everyone has to like disfrazar tu pavo so it doesn't look like a turkey.
Oh yeah, disguise it. Isabel had that for homework last week.
And I feel like that's something different too.
Because a lot of board games, I love them, but they don't have
La
Spanish.
Lotería?
And it's... Oh. Yeah, but I get bored. Like, I don't know. I love it. Like, bingo. Like, it's like we play that all the time. Like I want something and then you have to think and they're like, oh,
oh, toma todo.
También, pero también caro. Ese tampoco lo jugamos porque mi prima siempre quiere jugar ese. We're like, no, ¿a cuánto quieren jugar? And then they go out high. I'm like, oh,
no.
Says the people who have money. We don't have money. I don't even have quarters.
El del dólar dijo, sí, de dólar, de quarters. It's fun. Like, está divertido. But no, allá
no, si se gasta. Just
like, así poquito para...
And then to explain the game, porque we always have games in English, so we have to explain how do you do it in Spanish, and then alguien tiene que traducir todo el show y en veces no sale bien.
No, porque eso es una cosa, eso sí es cierto. Whenever you do like things in English, like games, like if you translate them into Spanish, no es lo mismo. O sea, no.
Aunque saben cuál sí está bueno, el no sabo. Que lo puedes decir en inglés o en español porque like parents here, I mean they have to know a little bit in English.
Maybe you could do
so you do it in English and they have to say que es en español y cómo se dice en inglés.
Como nosotros cuando decimos esta palabra es en español, ¿va? Así ellos, di esta palabra en inglés, a ver qué te dicen.
Sí, it's funny porque te ríes. Like we had one guy last year we played, no, not last year, we played for, what was it? I don't remember what we were celebrating, but donde tenían que decir lo más, I don't know, you have to go, bueno, let me tell you first. So you have to write, te hacen una pregunta y tú tienes que escribir lo primero que se te viene a tu mente. Y luego lo más común es, you're good. If you say something out of the blue, por decir, no, ya pierdes, puedes perder. Y you have the cow. And then when you're done writing the whatever you're writing, you have to go moo. It's so funny because todos se ríen moo y el que cae el último gets all pressured because everyone's moo. It's so awesome, man. There's some games out there that, oh my god, like te ríes porque some of them are like knowledge too, and it's funny because like we, one of the questions was, ¿qué lenguaje quisieras aprender si pudieras escoger cualquiera? Entonces alguien puso colombiano y luego like, colombiano no es un lenguaje, es un acento.
Ya.
Yeah. Y luego otra. Ah, otra contestó también algo y we're like, what? No, like, it's funny.
Yeah.
Can, yeah, it's,
te diviertes.
Sí, te diviertes.
Aprendes
sí.
Cosas.
Ajá, si no sabes, aprendes. But what about you? What are you grateful for? Sorry, we got off topic.
I'm grateful for God, honestly, and for all the teaching that I've been going through.
Mm-hmm.
For my health, my family's health, my family, for having our house, having food, for being able to be together. It's a blessing for a job. We have a job.
And we keep learning.
Yeah, and we keep learning as we keep growing.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
That's true.
Yeah.
What are you guys grateful for this year?
Yes.
Dijo rato, no me la conecta, soy tan risa, risa, nada muy buen. Aterrizamos.
From conspiracies to chismes to chuck.
Uh-huh. To grateful. To being ungrateful myself también.
Ay, Lene.
No, pues ya, yeah,
no, ya. Yeah. ¿Sabes una cosa? Que I feel que ahorita cuando estamos hablando, like, how our parents came here and everything,
mm-hmm.
like, that's also true, like, Thanksgiving is not celebrated in Mexico. That's culture here in the United States,
mm-hmm.
but not in Mexico.
Y le dicen el día del pavo, they don't say Thanksgiving y el día de acción de... Bueno, no. Some, es acción de gracias, uh-huh. pero decimos más bien el día del pavo.
El día del pavo, sí. No le dicen el día de acción de gracias.
Sí.
Pero, ¿qué te iba a decir? Antes, back in the day, y ahorita estamos hablando de eso, que back in the day, it was Thanksgiving, it was Black Friday, right?
Mm-hmm.
Y había descuentos y eran descuentos, descuentazos. ¿Y lo que nos ha pasado con el tiempo, Elena?
I was telling Lupita, there's this TikTok and it shows like every year, 2000, 2001 y así, like going every year. And think about it, guys. Primero, o sea, lo hacían el Black Friday, viene siendo el viernes, the day after Thanksgiving. And then they started doing it the day of Thanksgiving, when you're gonna be having your dinner. So like at 6, oh, let's do early. We're like, hello, like when are we gonna eat?
Mm-hmm.
So I guess it didn't work out that well. But now we're talking, me and Lupita, and think about it, guys. Now they do it a whole month in advance.
Mm-hmm.
Is it because they're not selling? Or is it because they sell more when they do that? Or what's going on?
Or is it just...
Marketing?
Marketing. Like, en realidad son descuentos. or in realidad it's just something to get you. Because I feel like it's just something to get you, honestly. Like, back in the day, honestamente, Irene, I'm real honest, si hacían descuentos. Like, yo me acuerdo actually having to go to the lines of the store and the store was closed. Pero sabes una cosa, se sentía la emoción.
La adrenalina.
Como que se sube la adrenalina. And I was like, yeah. Como like, está cerrado, we're in line, we got our tickets, whatever, que se estaban tickets a veces para lo que querés comprar. And it was like cool, like to see the people. Y luego había mucha policía.
People
would fight.
I think that still happens sometimes, pero.
And I just feel like now it's just like the whole month of November is Thanksgiving. Or Amazon también hace su week, su semana de Thanksgiving Pride, Black Friday, quién sabe qué.
And también tenemos Cyber Monday, I forgot.
Mm-hmm. And then now we added Cyber Monday. And honestamente, do you shop at Black Friday?
No more.
No. When was the last time you shopped?
I think I was pregnant from my daughter, which she's already 8, so like 8 years ago.
Years.
It was that time that it was at 6 o'clock when we're gonna eat turkey, so we put the turkey in the oven to cook yen más tarde. Y así cuando llegamos de shopping, ahora la comer. We went to JCPenney, I remember that time. What did we buy? I don't think I bought anything, but my mom and my grandma, I think that time, compró like a little microwave or that griddle. It was like very cheap. I think it was like $10. Damn, that was a long time ago. That thing was $10. No, it's like $30.
Mm-hmm.
And that discounted. Yeah, I think that was the last time, Lupita. I don't think. Did I go last year? Do I remember? No. What did we even do last year? I don't even remember. I have very bad memory, guys.
You know, the last time I went, and I still have it, it's when I bought my TV. I have it in my room.
Mm-hmm.
Todavía funciona. So it's good, because it's been like 12 years.
Damn.
That's the last time I went. And it was at those days, like, cuando sentía la adrenalina, and like, actually, like, buscabas, because before, ya ves como las tiendas te daban tu papelito con lo que iban a tener en oferta.
Sí.
Yeah. Like, it was, the like, those paper. Times, like, cuando buscaban los papeles y a ver qué nos convenía más or whatever, and we got on the line.
Damn, you would do your whole research and everything, yeah. Your whole mission.
Yeah. I was like, a ver, ¿dónde está más barata? Y no, que aquí, que no sé qué. I remember nos costó $500. And I was like, oh, I was so happy porque era la primera tele más grande que tenía, era de 50, ¿verdad? Pues para mí mm-hmm. estaba inmensa porque yo tenía una de 32. I was like, I was so happy and excited.
Uh-huh.
And esa fue la última vez que fui porque ya después de ahí, Elena, honestly, I started like, como que ya no me traía chiste, que se fue cuando empezaban como que, I know, a las 6. Y, you know, and I was like, a mí me gustaba que it was like Thursday and everything was closed. Mm-hmm. Bueno, ¿por qué? No sé, but I'm like, como Christmas mm-hmm. and everything, like all the stores are closed.
Uh-huh.
And I'm like, yeah, porque like it's Christmas, like people should be with their families. They mm-hmm. should be able to like
hear enjoy
their families, you
the
know
holiday.
What I mean? And now, no manches, o sea, el jueves ahí están abiertos todo el día, el viernes, el sábado, el domingo, and I'm like,
uh-huh. I was telling my cousin, because she works in a restaurant, and I tell her, oh, yeah, Friday, you're for sure. And Thursday, I don't think that you're going to be that busy, because people here celebrate like 12 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
And then us, like, at 6. So, ¿quién va a ir a comer? Pero el viernes, digo, oh, yeah, get ready, because ahí sí, todos van a ir shopping, y el shopping se van a ir a comer.
Yeah.
Una vez, el año pasado, I think I went to Texas Roadhouse on that Friday. Holy crap. Así de gente. Like, un chingo. Duramos lo que nunca hemos durado para esperar, like, 2 hours. And Texas Roadhouse is pretty good about sitting you right away.
Yeah.
Two hours.
Oh, my God.
Pobres, ese día, yo creo que quedaron.
Yeah, like,
rendidos.
No sé, like, I just feel like it's not the same.
No. ¿Será que porque ya no nos ponen, like, que cierran y lo abren y así? Like, ya no hay tanto. Como no te preparan para la. Como el evento, like, ¿cómo te digo?
Yeah, o sea, como que no te pone. Es que los seres humanos somos muy raros, ¿verdad? Cuando nos dicen que no, creemos a fuerza
sí.
que sí. Y como todo el tiempo está abierta la tienda, we're like, whatever.
Sí.
Pero cuando te cierran la tienda, justo es el día que te ocupas cosas.
Oh,
y justo es el
sí.
día que quieres ir.
Sí. Uh-huh. El 25 nunca falla. Y es, quiero ir a Walmart. And I'm like, oh, ah, what are they closed? But I'm like, Adilene, like, they tell you, we're going to be closing, so you better get ready. And we don't. We leave everything for last minute.
A mí sí me gusta comprar mis cositas y todo, pero honestamente, Elena, like, como, for example, my mind, okay? Pero for me, for example, like, como Thanksgiving, like, ya no me llama tanto la atención andar allá, entre la people. Como que I want peace and quiet.
Sí, es que para estarnos peleando por una tele o cosas así, porque me acuerdo que se peleaban cuando nomás hay 5 teles para esta hora y la gente se agarraba.
O cuando le rompían así las, because you know how they would have them like packed, uh-huh, es el plástico, uh-huh, y le rompía así la gente para empezar a agarrar las cosas. Damn. I know.
O sea, ¿era que antes sí estaban buenas las ofertas y ahora ya no tanto?
Pues a mí antes no se me hacían tan mal.
Sí.
Porque honestamente, like, everything has gone up.
Sí, pero and it's gonna continue.
Ya no vamos a comprar nada, pues qué vamos a comprar así.
O
no,
compras comida, compras cosas. Uh-huh. And then do we really need them? We can probably do without them too. I think for the most part. Stop doing that. Sorry guys. I've been doing, look, it's all red and estoy like, ah, es que te que it bugs me.
Yeah. Like, no sé, ya no se siente la misma emoción. Black Friday is not the same thing. No. I don't know about Cyber Monday. I have never bought nothing on Cyber Monday. Pero honestamente, it's the same thing because you always have ofertas en el internet, like all the time.
Siempre you can always find ahí. It somewhere else for cheaper.
Siempre están ahí mandándote emails y que ahora this promos y que now this y que use this coupon y que no sé qué.
And we're like, people get excited. That's how they get this.
Sí, así nos agarran con que nos vamos a ahorrar $2 y nos van a cobrar 700. Pero estamos ahorrando
o 20 de shipping.
Yeah,
truly.
Pero, I don't know, like, everything has changed and
it keeps changing.
It keeps changing and ¿qué podemos hacer?
Just enjoy it y appreciate it, dijo. Ya comprendimos.
Be grateful.
Sí, be grateful.
Anything else you want to add?
That's it, guys.
Well, we want to wish you guys a very happy Thanksgiving. We're grateful that you guys have supported us. We're thankful that you guys have come here to watch our videos. Thank you for the likes, the follows, the shares, the subscribes, the comments. Believe me, like, you guys made our days. Whenever we get a comment, whenever we get a like, it's such a blessing for us. And we want to thank you. We appreciate you. And we wish you a very happy Thanksgiving. See you in the next one. Bye.